Thank you. Thank you very much. Let's kick on. So our next piece, I need to tell you sort of a brief story. I think at least 20 years ago, we had Ed Reiser, who was playing carol singing in the Choral Society. And one day, the family brought me this poem. And it was by Ed's great aunt. It was entitled Forget Not the Heart. And they just said they found this in some attic or something. And what would I like to read? And so I read it through, and I was really moved by the poetry. And I thought, you know, I'm going to write something. I'm going to take this text, and I'm going to set it for the choir, an original composition of this text. And so I did. And it wasn't that good. We performed it, and it kind of, one year, it kind of got put in the bag, in the file cabinet, and that was the end of it. And so I was looking in the fall, I was getting my music organized and thought out of my head for this year, the repertoire for this year. And in the back of the cabinet, there was Forget Not the Heart. Oh, I remember that. Oh, I didn't like what I did too much with that. So I thought, I'm going to take this as one of my winter projects to rewrite this. And I kept some parts of it and did some fairly substantial rewrites on the other. And I like this, the way it turned out a lot better. And I hope the choir does, and I hope you do as well. We are very fortunate today to have the Reiser family with us. Ed is here. Ed, waving to everybody. His wife, Carol. Second edition of Forget Not the Heart. And I'm going to ask that Pastor David Poole, read the text for you, even though it's on the pulpit. And the reason I ask him to do this is because oftentimes when the text is written in the bulletin, you end up reading what's there and not listening to what's going on up here. So we're going to have David, even though you are all capable of reading, we're going to have Pastor Poole.
If words could satisfy the heart would find less care. But words, like summer birds, depart and leave but empty air. A little said and truly said can deeper joy impart than score of words that reach the ear but never touch the heart.
Thank you.
Ijames was discovered at a Christmas sing-along with the Parker family at our house. Dave, his wife, and their daughters, and they were having a Christmas carol sing. And Dave brought his violin, and one of their daughters brought her viola, and he sang. And he said, we had a great evening of Christmas singing, Christmas carols. And I said, Dave, you really play well. And I said, you know, a long time ago, when I was at Lakewood High School, we did a piece with violin and choir, but I can't remember the name of it. And I said, I'm going to check this out. And I'm going to, this was like a week before Christmas. And so the next morning, I got up and I went into J.W. Pepper's website. I typed in SAT choral music plus violin and piano. And this litany of music. And I started going through it and I saw the cover for this. I said, that's the piece. I hadn't done this in years and years and years and years. And that the violinist that did this last for us when I was teaching at Lakewood High School was the German teacher, who also happened to be a great violinist. So anyway, I got a copy of this thing today and I said, can you do this? And he said, absolutely. So we're going to now do Gene Butler's beautiful study of Gwen Frostick's poem, I Cannot Count the Stars. And I've asked Kathy Ott to read the poem.
Within the magic of the night, I feel their calm imploring. The rhythm of the golden waves, the winds that whistle, roar, and whisper, are part of one great harmony that plays within my heart. Swallows sweeping through the air, fireflies twinkling in the twilight, are all this soul of mine desires to keep it dreaming.